Today, Kat and I are gonna talk about wood grills. We're gonna talk about the most common questions that we hear about wood grills and make sure you as an architect are well informed about that type of product.
A wood grill is a ceiling panel where the slats are deeper than they are wide. A slat can be called a member. Some people call them louvers, but it's basically just where the wood member is oriented vertically. You can adjust the member width, the member depth. You can adjust the on-center spacing and reveal. So a reveal is the space between the slats, and it is what allows the sound to carry through and to kind of break up the visual impact of the grills. The on-center spacing is from the center of one slat to the next slat, and a lot of times we'll have lighting fixtures or diffusers that need to be a certain spacing, and so that's how we determine the on-center spacing. A lot of times is dictated by whatever you need to fit in between the slats.
So within our wood grills, we have a few different assembly types. We have our backers, which hold the slats together via a fire-rated black plywood. We have dowels, which is a real classic look where all the members are held together through a half-inch black dowel. We have a land system, which gives full access from the plenum. Then we have a dowel backer system that has dowels and backers. And then finally, we have our baffle system. The baffle is essentially one very tall or deep wood member that looks like a grill, but it's suspended individually by aircraft cable.
Typical wood grill module sizes are 1 foot, so 12 inches. The veneer sheets come in 8 foot and 10 foot lengths. And so within that we can, 4 foot lengths or 6 foot lengths. The solid wood grill panels can go up to 10, 12 feet sometimes. So it's the same width, but it can have longer lengths. So we do have a page on our website, which is titled Species and Finishes. You can also request a species box, and we can send out little 3x3 chips of the various species options. So a solid wood grill is ideal for a situation where you're going to have a lot of field cutting. It's also more beneficial because you have a variety of length structures, as well as being a lighter weight. A veneer wood grill is a good option if you're looking at a species that is going to be not economical, such as solid cherry or solid walnut. In those cases, you can get the appearance of that species without paying the premium for a solid wood. The main options that you have for finishes are clear. You can do a stain, which can either be a standard or a custom stain, or you can do opaque. So we can do stains on both solid and veneer. We found that stains work best on particular species. In order to create a custom color match, we would need some sort of a sample, a chip, or something that shows the color that you're looking for. So an opaque finish is going to have more of a paint-like appearance. You can do custom opaque finishes. The only things that we can't do are things like metallic finishes.
9-wood grill systems are designed to suspend from T-bar, usually a heavy-duty 15/16. And our detailing is going to be mostly for a T-bar suspension. However, we can do attachment to C-channel or hat channel or even wood furring or framing if it's in an exterior environment. We cannot attach wood grills directly to drywall. It needs to go through the drywall into something structural, and that's because a typical wood grill is around 3 pounds per square foot. 9-wood grills have a variety of access panel options. Some are on the more economical, simpler approach, and we also have some higher end, more expensive options with hinges and things like that. We definitely have a variety of solutions to make sure you have accessibility and that your maintenance teams can get up into the plenum. Wood grills typically are gonna be in the upper teens to lower 30s per square foot. Now there's a lot of factors that play into that. For example, species, stain, dimensions. So we can easily go higher than that, but generally speaking, you'll probably fall in that range.
A 9-wood standard product takes about 8 to 10 weeks for approvals, which includes shop drawings and some middle samples. And then it's 8 to 10 weeks for the fabrication and delivery of the product, which totals roughly 16 to 20 weeks. Ninewood's fast track program has lead times of 3 to 6 weeks, which does include shop drawings and samples. The Ninewood Design Assist team supports architects in assisting to write specifications and getting in process custom samples and finding the best product to match that design intent.
Thanks, Kat, that was great. You know, Kat is part of our team of design support specialists, and they have a lot of expertise to help you as an architect navigate all of this information. We really appreciate you watching the video today, and we'll see you next time.